Hello friends, so I take this opportunity to talk to you regarding the strategy for the last 30 days of Neet 2020. Even if you have not scored that well in the AIIMS exam or the PGI exam, how can you tremendously change your score and how can you actually perform in this upcoming exam? The first thing is forget about AIIMS, forget about PGI. Okay, if you keep on remembering those things, if you keep on focusing on how did you do your silly mistakes or what were your mistakes and how your result is not that good in these exams, you won't be able to perform in the next exam too. So now get ready for a bigger target. Always remember that every star may not shine on a single day. So that was a time for some other people, but your time is yet to come. Your failure is not cancelled, it is just postponed. So you have to now pull up your socks and get ready for a new and bigger target. Okay, first accept that yes, this has gone and now you have to do even much better in the upcoming exam. Okay, now what you have to do, ponder your mistakes in the AIIMS and PGI exam. You should see what was not that well, why did you failed in this exam, and try to collect your weaknesses. What were the mistakes that you did in these exams so that these mistakes are not repeated? The pattern of the exams that you give recently, the AIIMS exam or the PGI exam, are quite different from the pattern that you get in the NEET paper. So these exams should not be taken as the ultimate goal. Okay, now you should think that what are the mistakes you have already done in this. Try to jot down this on a piece of paper that yes, these were the mistakes I did in these papers. They can be any topics or they can be particular subjects or they can be the skill, the art of doing the MCQs. You were not able to pick up those things. So why you were not able to perform, write down this so that you can analyze your weak points. See, up till now you were preparing in one way. Okay, but now you are able to self-assess yourself that these are my weaknesses and these are my strength. And only when you know what are your weaknesses are, only then you can actually work on them and you can remove their weaknesses. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to apply your mirroring technique. Mirroring technique means identify your weaker subjects and also in these weaker subjects, what are your weakest topics, what are your weaker sections, and so that they become the most important topics for you. When you start studying and revising these 30 days, you should first look at these things which are actually went wrong in your previous papers so that you should not repeat them in the upcoming exam. Okay, now the next thing, no new stuff now. Now this is a very important thing because I have seen people, the students are always fond of increasing their volume and new stuff and their resources. Okay, now you have already made your notes, right? You have also collected lot of information around the year. Now from your classroom teaching, from your apps, from your vibe, I think now you should not collect any more new information and just you have to focus on your notes. Reading your notes once, twice or thrice, okay, instead of collecting more and more things and reading them even once, or maybe you are not able to revise them even once, is not a good idea. Instead of this, revising your notes again and again, I always tell this you in the class also, that 3 times revision is a must before going to the exam. If you have not revised, if you have not seen any particular subject, any particular topic at least thrice, then there is not a surety that you will be able to recall in your exams. And the important thing in your exam is how much amount you have been able to recall. Okay, if you have read much but you are not able to recall, then that is better, or you have read less but you are able to recall whole of it, that is better. So answer is recall. So if you have the things now, try to recall them, try to revise them again and again, and especially see those things again and again that you have done wrong in these papers. You have given now the GCLT too, okay? So that will also help you to actually do the mirroring of yourself. You cannot speak false, you cannot speak lie to yourself, okay? After giving this AIIMS paper, after giving this PGI paper, after giving your grand CLT, now you already know what are your weaknesses, what are your strengths. Now work on your weaknesses and maintain your strength. I repeat again, work on your weaknesses and maintain your strength. So you have to prepare your plan in such a way that your weaknesses are converted into your strength and your strength will remain your strength. So you have to maintain your timetable something like this, okay? Now, what are the things that you have to look for? Look your GCLT paper again. What things went wrong? What did you think, thought was right or not? Where did you actually fall short? And which subjects and which topics were not so good for you? Then always do the mock test. See, final rehearsal before going to the main exam is always important, because there is lot of anxiety, lot of apprehension before you appear in the final exam. So it's of utmost importance that you do the final stage rehearsal, the dress rehearsal, before appearing in the main exam. Because however confident you are, however subjects you have covered, how many topics you have covered, every time you appear in the exam, there is anxiety. And how can you reduce this anxiety? By appearing in those exams again and again. So I think these mock tests or the CLT exams, these give you a very good rehearsal of making yourself comfortable in that environment, because this exam is not just the exam of your academic knowledge. As I always say, it is also the exam of your courage, your patience, as well as the ability to recall. Then you have to look for your vibe also, because the visual image based questions also play a very key role in your NEET exam. And then the important thing is looking at the last year exam papers. When you are giving the NEET paper, you should look at least to the NEET papers 2018 and 2019. Why I'm not going very back? Because those exam pattern was quite different from these papers. So at least you should look to NEET 2018 paper, NEET 2019 paper, as well as 3-year AIIMS paper. We have compiled these papers for you in the form of a book. You can see those, or you have any other source, you can see that along with the detailed explanations. Look at them so that these questions are just at your tip and you do not do any mistake in these things. I do not say that these questions will be repeated as it is, but these topics are always high yield, and if you have prepared these topics well, what have been asked in the NEET 2018 and 19 along with your AIIMS paper, I definitely can say that about 60 to 70% of the paper will come from these topics which have been covered in these five papers, okay? Now, how to actually now start revising? That is a very important question in everyone's mind, that how to utilize these 30 days, how many days we should give to the preclinical, paraclinical, and so that we can have the maximum output, okay? Now, instead of going to hit and trial method, I have tried to prepare a genuine timetable for you people. See, what happens when you give this NEET paper, you'll be getting this paper in three sections, section A, B, and C, okay? This is the real pattern that you will get in your exam, the section A, section B, and section C, okay? Now, in section A, you will be getting your basic sciences, that is anatomy, physio and biochem. And the total number of questions will be 50, right? So you will have 17 from anatomy, 17 from physiology, and 16 from biochemistry. So you'll be having total 50 questions. Okay, then if you see the second section, in the second section we have the path, pharma, micro, along with the forensic medicine. So this accounts for about 75 questions, and this PSM will give you 25 questions. So this will give you a total of 100 questions. So we have 50 and then we have 100, and then we come to the clinical subjects. Now these clinical subjects will give you total of 150 questions. So it is 150 pre and para and 150 clinical. So I think all these subjects are important, but now you should know how to divide these subjects into the different days. So if you see here, you are having total of 300 MCQs, right? 150 are pre and para clinical, and then when 150 are clinical questions, together makes 300 MCQs that you have to actually work and revise in 30 days. You have total of 30 days. So what I have tried to do, I have divided this 30 days with the 300 MCQs. So for every subject, you have 1/10. Okay, so 1/10 of the days into the number of MCQs that you are getting in particular subject. Okay, so what do you mean, what do I mean by this? Suppose I have 50 MCQs which are coming from the anatomy, physio and biochem. Okay, so that means 1/10. So I have 5 days. So I can allot 5 days for these basic sciences, the anatomy, physio and biochem. Now amongst these 5 days, you can divide according to your convenience and according to your stronger as well as weaker subject. If you feel like that you want to give more time to anatomy, then you can accordingly divide this time. Suppose I want to give 2 days for the anatomy, right? Then I am left with the physio and biochem 3 days. So I can give 1.5 and 1.5. So this can be different for the individual. But total of 5 days you can give for anatomy, physio and biochem. Similarly, your next one, next section was having the 100 questions. So this was having like the pharma, and then it was having the patho, then it was having the micro, right? Then it was having forensic medicine and then the PSM. Okay, so total of this was 100 questions, 100 questions divided by 10. So I'll be having 10 days. So I have total of 10 days for these subjects. Now, according to the individual subjects, like pharma has 20 MCQs, so this means 2 days, okay. Patho, this is 25, so I can get 2.5. Micro, 20, so again 2. Similarly, we have forensic also, and PSM. PSM has 25 questions, so this will give me 2.5. So in this fashion, again, I can divide the number of days based on the number of MCQs that I am getting. And then 150 from the clinical. 150 from the clinical means divide by 10. So I have got 15 days for my clinical subjects. So I can divide 15 for pre and paraclinical, and then 15 days for the clinical. Now, one thing more I want to emphasize, when you are revising these, like I have given 5 days for anatomy, physio, biochem, then I have given 10 days for the this one, your paraclinical things, and then I have given 15 days for the clinical. You divide your single day when you are reading any particular subject in also 2/3 and 1/3. Also divide your day into 2/3 time and 1/3 time. I want you to spend 2/3 of the time in revising the theory, right? And 1/3 of the time in revising the MCQs, Now, what these MCQs are? These MCQs can be the bookmarked MCQs that you have done round the year, and now see those bookmarked MCQs in this time. Also, you can see the last year questions this time, the recent papers that have gone, because I want you to keep a practice of the MCQs also, because if you are not doing the MCQs for the last 30 days, this can severely deteriorate your speed of doing MCQs, and that is again a very important limiting factor in your exam, because I have seen people who knew all the questions which they left, but they were not able to manage the time. And this time management should not be a limiting factor in your exam. So take a stopwatch, try to do the MCQs, and if you see how much time you should allot to a particular MCQ. Now again, I have got a very genuine analysis for you. We have got 300 MCQs in the exam and we get total of 3 hours 30 minutes, so that accounts for about 210 minutes, and 210 minutes into 60, these many seconds. So one MCQ is giving you roughly 42 seconds. So you have about 42 seconds for one MCQ. Now some MCQ you will be able to do in 5-10 seconds, okay, but some MCQs will take minute or 2 minutes or 5 minutes or 10 minutes. So wherever you are able to save time, I will say save the time, so that you are able to put in those extra seconds or minutes to those MCQs that require time. Take an instant decision after reading that question, that are you going to attempt this question? Do you have a fair knowledge about this question? If you have a very good knowledge and you are able to solve, then it is okay. Then if you do not know this question, then analyze. Do you have enough knowledge that you can attempt this question, because you have 25% of negative marking also. So based on this, you should actually take a decision that are there more chances of getting this question right or more chances that you will get it wrong. And then you have to take the decision whether to attempt this question or not. Okay. Now, what is the next important thing? The smart study. Smart study is the need of our gone are the days that when only hard study was the answer. Now you have to study hard and even smartly. So first you have to divide your 30 days into 15 and 15, then you have to divide your 15 days into 5 days for the basic sciences, then you have to divide the remaining 10 days according to the marks distribution into your patho, pharma, micro, forensic and PSM. Then you have to divide your next 15 days into the clinical subjects. These clinical subjects again divide your time based on the marks distribution. You can go one day here and there according to your weakness, your strength. Then divide 2/3 of the time in their theory and 1/3 into the MCQs. Now in that 2/3 of the time when you are seeing the theory, first see the theory of high yield points. Now where from you will get these high yield points? I have recorded a separate video on the high yield topics of the ophthalmology. Then you will get the high yield topics from the recent AIIMS exam, PGI exam, from your grand CLT. You will get the high yield topics from your last year AIIMS paper. Okay, there is a book which is giving you all this information along with the detailed answer, plus those things that you tend to forget, because I told you that recalling in the exam is of utmost importance. If you are doing very hard and if you have learned everything but you are not able to recall in the exam, I think that is a waste. Plus the time that you gave these things to revise also gone into waste. Okay, so plan your time very smartly so that you can do wonders in this 1 month or the 30 days. And this is not a miracle, you can do it, and I have seen people doing it. If you plan your study very very systematically, I told you the pattern of questions that are asked in NEET. We have divided in the different sections, and please divide your timetable also in these sections only of A, B, C. Okay. Now, what are the tiebreaker questions? The tiebreaker questions. Tiebreaker questions means that sometimes if one or two candidates are getting a tie, then how to break this tie? In that category, the C section questions are given a priority over B section questions, and they are given a priority over the A section questions. So what I mean to say that the clinical subjects are always given a priority over the pre and paraclinical. So you, when you are actually revising and making your strategy, try to be very confident about these clinical subjects and try to do as many as clinical questions as you can. They are comparatively easy to do also, because it's easier to revise and to recall the clinical subject in comparison to pre and paraclinical when you have the hard dry core knowledge and you have to actually rectify the facts. So I think clinical things are more easy to comprehend. You can even interrelate it with the help of the visual. You have already attended the vibe session. We have tried to integrate the theory along with the visuals, and so many visuals you are able to remember along with whole of the theory. Just by the visual only, you can recall everything. Like one was the beautiful mouse, the blue baby boy. Okay, so always when you are doing the question and you are in a fix that how many questions to do, always do the questions in this order. Okay, do more of the clinical questions, because in cases of any tie, the person who has done more of the clinical questions will be given more weightage, and you will certainly have an edge over the others. Okay, along with this, another important thing is the recent updates. Like nowadays, there is a trend in the exams of asking the recent updates, and we keep on updating these recent updates about the different programs or any new changes that has come in the latest editions or any other thing over our groups, our pages. So I think you must have the collection of those. And try to see those updates again, because just before going to the exam, if you see them again, there is more probability that you are able to recall them in the exam. Okay. Now, another very important thing is to remain positive. I think there is a tug of war between the positivity and the negativity in this 30 days. And whenever we try to remain positive, there are so many people around, there are so many factors around, there are so many things which will actually always pull you towards the negativity. You will think again, why I was not able to do well in this exam, I am reading but I am not able to recall. And there are so many moments when you must be feeling low, and feeling of quitting, or the depression may be coming into your mind. The idea is that you are going into the negativity by default. So you have to make efforts to remain positive. So always remain in the surrounding of positive people, see the positive videos, stay away from negativity, stay away from negative people who always try to make you negative, who always try to curse you, who always try to show you the lesser good side of yourself. So you have to actually remain yourself. You have to make yourself positive by so many measures. It can be seeing the motivational videos, or staying away from the negative people by whatever means, whatever you like. Listen some good music, some good people, motivated people. Talk to your parents, because parents are one people who will never make you feel low or depressed, who will never hurt your self-respect. So I think good friends or the parents are the best people to talk to them in your free time. Okay, so remain positive. And then final dress rehearsal before the big day. So that is very, very important, because whenever you appear for any big exam, obviously you are having a lot of anxiety, a lot of apprehension. If I say, okay, go and you don't have any anxiety there, so that is not correct. Obviously, that is a must component. You will have that. But you can reduce them by appearing in the similar situation. We can simulate those situations in the form of mock tests. And you can actually reduce your anxiety by appearing in a similar exam, similar ambience, similar everything before going to that actual exam. So that will actually reduce your anxiety very much. Considerably a lot, so that when you actually appear in your final exam, you don't feel that it is the first time, it's your first time, because the feeling of doing anything for the first time always gives you anxiety. Okay, so if you have done that thing many times, that you will feel more familiar, more confident, and much relaxed. So this is the way you have to go. Appear in the mock test also, appear in the final exam. And then I would say that in the last days, when you have completed this 30 days, if you start your timetable from tomorrow also, still you will be left with about 2 days. Now in these final 2 days, look at your vibe booklet, look at your recent updates, look at the forgettables. If you have any forgettables that you have marked the list, or you have those weaker things that you have marked from the particular subjects, particular topics, please look at them, and look at the last year NEET paper very, very thoroughly just before going into the exam once again. NEET paper 2019 should be on your tips. So this was the thing. Now, one thing I want to say, you should be able to bounce back. Don't actually get depressed by your NEET, by your AIIMS score or your PGI score or your CLT score or your mock score. You should be able to bounce back. How hard you have gone, bounce back with two times more recoil. So if you recoil and if you bounce back with a stronger impact, you will be able to perform in NEET 2020. So I, on the behalf of the whole of the team DBMCI, would like to say all the very best. Do your very best in your exam, and we are waiting for your flying colors in the upcoming exam. Thank you.